Get Rich Education is brought to you by Narada Real Estate Corporate Direct and Ridge Lending Group. Cashflow real estate investors, this is Get Rich Education's Keith Weinhold. Did you know that you can finance up to 35 income properties all with one lender? Ridge Lending Group specializes in investment property loans, and they do it in almost every U.S. state. Ridge has worked with tens of thousands of real estate investors and homeowners all over the country. They've been doing this for investors for so long that at this point, they've helped more families realize their dreams of becoming real estate investors than any other mortgage lender in the country. To find out more, visit RidgeLendingGroup.com.
Welcome to Get Rich Education with Keith Weinhold, giving you information and ideas on the investment that has turned more ordinary people into millionaires and billionaires than anything else, and can provide you with more wealth and happiness than you ever thought possible. Now, here's your host, investor, entrepreneur, business owner, and educator, Keith Weinhold.
Welcome to Get Rich Education. This is episode 103. I'm your host, Keith Weinhold. Today, we're getting energized and you're learning from dynamic rich dad tax advisor, Tom Wheelwright. He's a regular contributor here at Get Rich Education. Now, Get Rich Education is not the show for you if you've got 15 minutes to fill out an online survey to get half off an oil change at Jiffy Lube or some zero impact nonsense like that, okay? We don't play fantasy football here. I don't know the latest on Calvin Johnson's hamstring. Kind of fun, but not really impactful. We're here to help you construct a sound wealth building strategy for your life and your heirs. Part of that is permanently reducing your taxes. Well, what's better than reducing your taxes? It's completely eliminating your taxes. Now, that takes a knowledgeable firm, and we're talking with the founder and visionary of the world's top tax strategy firm today. Otherwise, taxes will be your biggest expense in this life of yours, and there's nothing wrong with cutting expenses when that expense is taxes, and that's one expense that does not diminish your lifestyle when you cut it. So let's chat with Tom Wheelwright. Today's guest is a flat-out tax genius, and he's a wealth expert. He's a best-selling author, CPA, and CEO of ProVision Wealth, based in Tempe, Arizona. By this point, you know who he is. He's best known for making taxes fun, easy, and understandable. He and I are both contributing writers at the Rich Dad Advisors blog, where you can read our work at richdadadvisors.com. Tom is an elite Rich Dad Advisor himself to Robert Kiyosaki, where he frequently speaks at Rich Dad conferences globally. His work has been featured in Forbes. He's a regular contributor here at Get Rich Education, and his firm, ProVision Wealth, also provides tax strategy for my wife and I, plus they actually prepare our taxes every year. You can learn more at taxfreewealthadvisor.com. And, you know, most people find taxes boring, but when you talk about it with Tom, this just somehow gets completely flipped upside down, and you soon start to feel like you're in the center of the action somehow. Welcome back to Get Rich Education for your fourth appearance, Rich Dad Advisor Tom Wheelwright.
Hey, thanks, Keith. It is always great to be on your show. Wish I were in Anchorage because I'm sure it's a little cooler than it is here in Arizona, but it's just great. So very happy to be here. It's been a very exciting year and look forward to more.
Oh, yeah. This time of year in Anchorage, if you're a person that wants to be active outside like you and I, this is just totally ideal. Well, every dollar of income that one has is taxable or not. And one thing I think a lot of people don't understand, Tom, is something of double taxation or multiple taxation that wears down their $1 of income to significantly less. Tell us more about that.
Well, so here's what I think people don't really realize. You know, people, they're always talking about, well, you know, what kind of returns am I going to get on my investment? And is this a good deal? And so forth. But what they fail to realize is that as long as you're paying taxes and multiple taxes on that dollar, you're never going to get where you want to be. It's practically mathematically impossible to get beyond getting by. And that's why typical financial advisors, they're going to tell you, the first thing they ask you when they start with you is, how much do you need to retire? Because they're looking at the bare minimum. They're not looking at what you want. They're just looking at what you need. Okay, well, the reason is because if you're paying tax, if you're paying these high taxes, and I'm not talking about, we're not talking about tax deferral, okay, like we do in an IRA, like the financial advisor is talking about. We're talking about real tax reduction, where it's permanent tax reduction. If you're paying these high taxes, and by the way, if you're in that IRA, you're going to be paying high taxes later when you pull the money out. So if you're doing that, you just cannot get there. Think about this. So think about all these dollars that are coming in. Let's go through some of the taxes.
Okay.
You're paying income tax. That's the one that everybody thinks about. You're paying Social Security tax. You're paying of some sort, Medicare or net investment income. If you're in real estate, you're paying some type of Social Security taxes, probably. You're paying property tax. You're paying sales tax. If you like to do anything that is considered a vice, you're paying a tax. Cigarettes, gambling all have taxes. You have taxes on tourism taxes. You have huge gas taxes. You have alternative minimum tax, you have gift taxes, you have use taxes. We have a list of like 20 different taxes that you pay on pretty much every dollar you earn, unless you don't. I thank you for using that term. Every dollar you earn is either taxable or not.
Right.
And it's really that simple. The key to building wealth really is two things. It's debt and taxes, right? It's leveraging your money. And it's leveraging the tax dollars that you would otherwise give away. Because if you give all that money away to the government, you're likely to end up with less than 40 cents for every dollar you pull in. And the big one is income tax. Because anybody who's doing well in, by the way, any country, I know we're talking to primarily U.S. people, but I just got back from Africa and Australia. And I'll tell you that our tax rates are actually lower than most of the rest of the world. And everybody in the world who makes any kind of money at all is in about a 40%, anywhere from a 35 to 40% tax rate. That's just on your income. That's just your income tax. And that amount of tax is really what it ends up doing. It just steals your life. I mean, it just robs you from all of the benefit you could have. I'll give you a simple example. So if you were to invest $10,000 today, and you were to invest it for 30 years and you got a 10% return on that money, and you just continue to put that money back in and reinvested it and continue to get the 10%, and you pay a 40% tax rate on the earnings on that $10,000, then you end up with $60,000 after 30 years, which people go, wow, that's six times, that's pretty good. But if you didn't pay tax, you'd end up with $200,000.
It's the compounding effect, yeah.
It's the compounding effect of not paying taxes. And so you have the opposite. You have a compounding effect of paying taxes. I think this is something that people, they hate to think about it. They don't want to think about taxes. Oh, I'm telling you, this is a very exciting subject. Who doesn't want to trade $60,000 for $200,000? I mean, it's a huge number.
Yeah, that's right. And, you know, there's some people listening thinking, well, I don't pay a 60% tax rate on anything, so my dollar of income isn't worn down all the way to 40 cents. But just like with all the taxes you mentioned, it is. What if you pay a 30% income tax rate? Now your dollar's down to 70 cents. With that 70 cents left over, you're still having to pay your property tax. You're still having to pay your sales tax and everything else. So by the time double or even multiple taxation kicks in, it depends on which state you live in and other factors, of course, but that's why one commonly only has 40 cents left over from their dollar.
It's just shocking. We think we're earning this money. And I'll give you an example. I have a good friend. He's actually one of my physicians. And he's a great guy and does amazing work. He's just amazing. And he was just talking the other day about how he finally broke $1 million in net income. He goes, the only problem is he paid half of it in tax. So he just keeps paying so much in taxes, and that's just income tax, pay so much in taxes, it's like we keep working, but we just seem to never get ahead. We never have money to invest. And that's actually why real estate investing is such a good vehicle, and it's such a better vehicle from a, like you say, a compounding effect, because you compound so many different things. You compound your depreciation by doing a couple of things, cost segregation, which we can talk about, as well as your debt. Compounds it, and you compound your, you get amortization benefits. You're amortizing that loan down, but your tenant is paying for it. You get appreciation. Hopefully, you know, it's going up in value. It's not going down value. So besides your cash flow, so you're really actually getting paid four different times for real estate, which is probably the only place you can go where you can get paid four times.
yeah, truly multidimensional. And yeah, one can even benefit from an inflation hedging benefit when they tie up long-term fixed interest rate debt. You bring up depreciation, one of the really magical advantages that a real estate investor has. And I know you've been traveling with Robert Kiyosaki lately, and you have a great example to help people understand how depreciation works. Tell us about that.
Well, so let's say you have $200,000 to invest. Let's say you were to invest that in the stock market. All right, you invest in the stock market. What tax break do you get? Well, the only tax break you get is that eventually when you sell that stock, if you hold it for a year and a day, and under Hillary's plan, 6 years and a day, you're going to get a lower tax rate. Okay, instead of 40%, you know, you get to 20%. Instead of 30%, you get a 15%. So you basically get half the tax rate when you sell it. But you get no immediate tax break. You get no tax break against your other income. Real estate, business, and oil and gas, actually all three of these, you get immediate tax benefits. But real estate, you get a compounded tax benefit, because when we talk about real estate, we're always talking about using other people's money, right? I mean, you just talked about interest rates. I have a good buddy who's a real estate developer, and he calls it, it's like buying cheap heroin, the interest rates right now. They're so cheap. You just want to get as much of it as you can, as fast as you can. And the reason is because it compounds your returns, but what it also does is it compounds your tax benefits. So think about this. If you took that $200,000 and you paid cash for a property, if you do a cost segregation, you'd get about $20,000 of depreciation a year for the first few years. If you take that and you leverage it and you borrow 80% loan to value, so you buy a $1 million property, now instead of getting a $20,000 deduction, you're going to get $100,000 deduction. In a, let's take your 30% tax rate. If you're in a 30% tax rate, that's like instead of getting $6,000 back from the government a year, instead you're going to get $30,000 back from the government a year.
Everything. Yeah. So when we talk about leverage, we're usually thinking about appreciation. But in this example, you're leveraging depreciation at the same time.
That's right. That's exactly what you're doing. Here's the thing. Just remember, the bank doesn't get a deduction for depreciation.
Right.
Only you do. So you get the bank's depreciation. They're putting the money in, but you get the depreciation. It's pretty magical.
It is. Most investors, most people think it's magical if they can get their money working for them. Real estate investors and advanced investors like us know that the real magic takes place when you maximize using other people's money. Right there is a great example. What about depreciation on a property? Let's put some numbers to that.
So Keith, here's a very simple example of how depreciation really works. I mean, let's say that you've got a $1 million building, and let's say that on that $1 million building, you have cash flow of $100,000. Okay, so after you've paid your debt service, after you paid all your expenses, you got cash flow of $100,000. Well, on that $1 million building, so that $100,000 cash flow, if you got that anywhere else, you'd pay tax at your regular tax rates, 30 to 40%. Okay, and you'd be out that money. But with real estate, on that $1 million building, you're going to get, do a cost segregation, you're going to get about $100,000 deduction for depreciation. So even though you've got $100,000 of cash flow, your taxable income from that is zero.
Remarkable.
You're not going to pay any tax on that cash flow. I mean, $100,000 cash flow on a $1 million building is really good cash flow, right? You've got, if you've leveraged it, so you've got all this great cash flow, not taxable. That's what we call tax-free wealth. What I found, and I run all these calculations because I'm on stage with Robert so much, and we want to make it really simple. It turns out that if you do a cost segregation, now remember, when you buy a piece of real estate, you're really buying four things. You're buying the land, which even the IRS understands doesn't wear out.
Right.
So you don't get a deduction for the land. You're buying the land, you're buying the building, and most CPAs, when they do depreciation, they just break it out, land and building. And in fact, if you don't do a cost segregation, that's really all you get to do. The IRS doesn't allow you to do more than that. But if you do a cost segregation, which is where you hire a professional, I know you've done this, Keith. So yeah, you hire a professional to come in, an engineer slash accountant. Typically, you do both. But when you hire somebody to come in and you do these cost segregations, then what they do is they break it down into two more areas. And one area is land improvements. And those are things like fencing and paving and your landscaping and everything else that has to do with the land itself, that's an improvement to the land. And then you have the contents of the building. Well, the contents of the building, you normally think of, well, what are the contents? You know, I don't really have very much in contents. The tenants have to, bring in their own washer, dryer, and so forth. Yeah, but actually the contents include the hookups to those washer and dryer. The contents actually include the cabinets, include almost everything but the plumbing, because whatever you don't need to function as a building is contents. Well, the difference is that a residential building, we get a depreciation deduction about 3.5% a year, but a contents, we get a depreciation deduction of 20% a year. So we're trying to push as much as we can in there. Well, the great thing about cost segregation, as you and I have discussed before, is that you go to a good cost segregation person, expert, and they will actually give you an estimate of the benefit, the tax benefit, before they ever charge you a dime. I mean, where else can you get that, where you know what your return on investment is before you ever spend the money? That's pretty cool. And what happens is, instead of getting 3.5%, we end up with an average of about 10%. So we've basically tripled our depreciation deduction for that first 5 years. And we want that money. Why do we want that depreciation deduction earlier? Because that means that we have more money to put into more properties right off the bat. And as you know, Keith, real estate is really what I call it, a volume business, right? The more volume you have, the more money you make. But the other thing is, the more volume you have, the less tax you pay. People look at my book, Tax Free Wealth, say, how do you get to tax free? Real estate's probably the easiest way to get there. I mean, it takes a few years. You've got to build up your volume in real estate. But because of the depreciation tax benefits are so good in real estate, frankly, I'm convinced it's why Donald Trump won't release his tax return. It's because I can't believe he's paying any taxes. Why would he? All that real estate he's got, all that debt he has, he would have to have a tax advisor that's a complete idiot to be paying any tax. So, of course, he doesn't want to release his return. I mean, look what happened to Mitt Romney, 13%. He got hammered for it, right? He was just following the tax law. Well, Mitt Romney had actually used a loophole in the tax law. What Donald Trump's doing is he's just using the tax law as it's intended, completely as it's intended. So he's doing something, he's building real estate, et cetera. And whether you love Donald Trump or hate Donald Trump or anywhere in between, doesn't really matter. The tax law is what it is, and their tax benefits, the tax law is just a series of incentives. And real estate carries huge incentives with it. So you can complain all you want about the rich not paying taxes, but I'll tell you what, I'll give you another example. I've got another client I was talking to just the other day, and he said that when he started with us 3 years ago, he was paying $370,000 a year in tax, and today he's down under $7,000.
That's a stunt.
Why? Because his real estate went from 30 units to 2,300, and that's why he's down to $7,000. It's really that simple of a computation.
Right, which is counterintuitive to some people. And when you're a public figure and you're a savvy investor and you release your tax returns, that can outrage the public because, as we know, the public does not understand the tax law and the wealthy do. Now, with the cost segregation, yeah, you brought up something very interesting. When I engaged ProVision, Tom, and you referred me to the cost segregation engineer, there was real value in engaging that cost segregation engineer. He let me know what my savings were going to be, and he let me know what his services were going to cost. And that's an ROI. That's a return on investment. That's an investor decision that one is making right there. And if you choose not to engage them, you don't owe them a dime. So it's really a brilliant way to do it. You're listening to Get Rich Education. Our guest is Rich Dad Advisor Tom Wheelwright. More when we come back. I'm your host, Keith Weinhold.
Garrett Sutton here, Robert Kiyosaki's asset protection attorney and the author of Loopholes of Real Estate. As an American or foreign-based investor in U.S. real estate, you know we are a litigious society. You know that you need to protect your real estate and paper asset holdings with the right mix of LLCs and corporations. My firm, Corporate Direct, not only forms these entities, but importantly, we properly maintain them too. If you fail to follow the corporate formalities, you can lose it all in an instant. Corporate Direct is your source for LLC protection and maintenance in all 50 states. Visit CorporateDirect.com or call 800-600-1760. Mention Get Rich Education for a free bonus. Switch your resident agent service to us and receive another bonus. It's all good. We look forward to assisting you at CorporateDirect.com.
Are you having a hard time finding great investment properties? Unfortunately, the best deals are rarely found locally. Successful investing begins with the right properties in the right markets. Norada Real Estate provides everything you need to invest in the best deals across the U.S. Our simple, proven system will help you create real wealth and passive monthly cash flow. Get your free copy of The Ultimate Guide to Passive Real Estate Investing at noradarealestate.com/guide. That's NORADA realestate.com/guide.
This is Rich Dad Advisor Gareth Sutton. To grow your wealth, listen to the always valuable Get Rich Education.
Welcome back to Get Rich Education with Rich Dad Advisor Tom Wheelwright, ProVisionWealth.com. Tom, what are some of the most frequently asked questions that you get over there at ProVision from real estate investors?
Number one question I get, and I do a webinar with our clients twice a month, and I just did one last night, and really there are two big ones. And the first one is, when do I start? In other words, if I'm just starting into real estate, do I need to do a tax strategy? Do I need to do an asset protection strategy? And I love Garrett. I know Garrett advertises on the show here. I love Garrett's response to this. He says, well, you don't put the seatbelt on after the accident.
Right.
And that's exactly right. I mean, with asset protection, you have to put it on ahead of time. And you don't know. It could be 2, 3, 4 years down the road when somebody comes back at you. So everybody knows that the more money you have, the bigger the target is on your back. So as you start building your real estate, building your wealth, you're going to have tenants are always, they're always targeting their landlords. I always joke that if you look up tenant in the dictionary, all it says is plaintiff.
I either like that or I really don't like that.
It's like when I was first learning to ride a motorcycle and, you know, they'd ask you the question. So the question is not whether you will lay your bike down. The question is when you will lay your bike down. And the same is true with asset protection. The question is not whether you've been sued. The question is, have you been sued yet? Because chances are you're going to get sued. It's interesting. Garrett and I were with Robert down in Santiago, Chile in the spring, and he asked this question. He said, how many of you have been sued? And a good third of the hands went up. And this is in Chile. It was shocking. And we were in Australia together. He asked the same question, and only 3 hands went up. But then, of course, the next question is, how many of you have not been sued yet? Because the chances of you getting sued, if you're particularly if you're a property owner in the U.S., are very, very high. And so there are things you need to do to protect yourself right away. Now, insurance is the obvious one. And don't let anybody tell you, don't do insurance, because I think an umbrella policy is one of the wisest investments you will ever make.
Oh, and it's so cost effective.
Oh, it's cheap. And here's what I think the most important thing you get with an umbrella policy. You get the attorneys for the insurance company. And you get the adjusters for the insurance company. The one time I've had a tenant threaten to sue me, property manager went to the insurance company. Insurance company gets with the tenant and the attorney for the tenant. I get a couple of questions, and that's all I ever hear because the insurance company just handled it. So getting prepared early on from an asset protection standpoint, it's clearly critical. So using Garrett for that, I mean, I highly recommend Garrett. We do a lot of work with Garrett. Garrett's awesome. The other side is tax. And people go, well, yeah, but I don't have, you know, much in the way of taxes that I'm paying now. You know, I'm sure some of our listeners here are long-term investors and some are probably flipping properties. Those who are flipping properties, it only takes one to have a huge tax bill. I mean, think about this. If you make $50,000 profit on a fix and flip, you could be paying taxes over 50% on that one deal. And the thing is, once you close on that deal, you can't go back. In fact, you can't go back and do tax planning once you started the deal. So you have to do this right now. I mean, this is not something that you wait for. You do your tax and asset protection strategy. You do it as early as possible. By the way, it's also way less expensive if you do it early because A, you haven't made a lot of mistakes, but B, it's not difficult to set it up, which really comes to the same question, which is, this is what I spent all night on last night was, what type of entity should I use? And entity being, how should I hold my real estate? And most people, it's just going to depend on, are you investing long-term? In other words, are you renting the property or are you flipping the property? If you're flipping the property, remember that you are a business. I would urge you not to consider an investment. You're spending your time, but it's not an investment. It's a business.
Right.
So treat it like a business and act like a business and know that the tax law treats you like a business too. So whereas if you're investing for the long term in real estate, you're not going to pay regular Social Security taxes, self-employment taxes. You are on your fix and flip. So you'd better set it up that way. So typically, most people are going to want to be, depending on the state they're in, they're going to want to be a limited liability company for asset protection purposes. And if they're flipping, they're going to want to be taxed as an S corporation. On the other hand, if you are buy and hold, then you're going to want to be in limited liability company again, but you're probably going to want to have a holding company in Wyoming, because Wyoming, as Garrett will tell you, has such good asset protection laws on the LLC. And then you're going to want to have subsidiary LLCs that actually own the property. And those are not going to be taxed as an S corporation. In fact, the worst thing you can do is put real estate into a corporation from a tax standpoint, because it causes all sorts of tax problems. Absolutely gives you no tax benefit. So I would just urge everybody who's listening, if somebody's told you to put your real estate into a corporation and you're buying and holding, you're not flipping it, you're buying and holding it, so you're renting it out, run. Just get away from that advisor, because that is a bad idea. In my mind, it's right on the edge of malpractice to tell somebody to put their real estate into a corporation. And Garrett will tell you the same thing from an asset protection standpoint. Corporations are not good anyway, but from a tax standpoint, it's really bad. Even if it's an LLC and gets the asset protection and you're taxing as a corporation, just don't do that when you're doing buy and hold real estate. Those are probably the two top questions that I get, is when do I start? And the other question is, you know, what type of entity? I'll give you a third one if you want a third one, Keith.
Yeah.
Okay. So the third one is, I'm afraid of an audit. If I take all these tax deductions, will it raise a red flag?
Right.
And I'll tell you, every time I'm on stage, I always ask the question to the audience, how many of you have been told not to take a deduction because it would raise a red flag?
I bet a lot of hands go up.
80, 90% of the hands go up. And what's really interesting in the U.S. when I ask that question is I always follow it up with, for how many of you was it the home office deduction that you were told not to take? And most of the hands stay up.
Yeah.
And I'm going, okay, so let me get this straight. We have a deduction that is specifically allowed in the tax law, and your accountant is afraid to take it because it will raise a red flag. I will tell you two things. First of all, if you do it right, the government doesn't even know you have a home office. It used to be you had to highlight it, and you don't anymore. So that's the first thing I tell you. Second thing I tell you is, if somebody tells you this is a red flag and it's a legitimate deduction, then all they're telling you is that they're afraid of the IRS. And really my question for you is, do you really want a professional working for you who is afraid of the IRS?
Exactly. That's so backwards. The investor is not being served by that tax company at all, because fear is controlling the situation. So these laws are written specifically to advantage the person that the tax preparer wants to take away that advantage from. That is so backwards.
It is. And it really is a case of the tax preparer is afraid of an audit. And I'm going, why would you be afraid of an audit? If you're doing what you're supposed to do and the client understands and you're educating your client, here's my number two complaint about tax preparers. Number one is when they say, advise you to not take a deduction. Number two is that they are so afraid of the IRS. And the reason is that they're afraid that the client is going to be upset with them. I mean, that's really what it is. It's not that they're afraid of the IRS, they're afraid of the client. Because what they're not doing is they're not educating the client. Advisors, you want to choose a good advisor, choose an advisor who will educate you. I'll tell you, I'm going to talk about my friend Garrett again, because he's a blast to travel with. He's great to be on stage with, great to travel with, but he is a great teacher.
Yeah.
And he always explains it really clearly as to what's going on and why it's going on. That's why we love having mutual clients with him, because it makes it so much easier for us. Because when a client understands what's going on, now I'm off the hook because I've explained it to the client. Client understands it. So why would the client blame me for it? They know what they're doing. They know that they're taking this deduction. What happens is that the tax return, most people's tax returns, when they have a tax preparer do it, is a black hole. They have no idea what's in that tax return. They never sit down with their tax preparer. They never go through it. They never understand what the strategies are. You know, September and October are really busy for tax preparers, because this is when our more complicated returns get done, and we've got, you know, due dates in September and October, and it's like you don't get to postpone it, right, like you do in March and April. So what happens is, Bo, when we're preparing tax returns, we're actually looking at how do I save this taxpayer money? Because while we're not planning, we are looking at opportunities to save money on the tax return. I was doing one recently. We saved them $50,000 in like 10 minutes on the tax return.
What's the return on that? Incredible.
Can you imagine that? $50,000 in tax. You know, he's paid for his tax returns for several years there. It's a breeze. And the thing is that with this particular client, we're going to say that every year. That's what happens when you have the right tax preparer. So I think that the biggest mistake people make is not using the right advisor. I actually think that's a huge mistake. And I've made the mistake. I got divorced a few years back. My attorney was an absolutely complete idiot. My fault. I hired him. So it was my fault. I'm just saying I chose poorly that advisor. Blair Singer, another Rich Dad advisor, who's one of my best friends, he has a saying. He says that the higher the emotion, the lower the intelligence.
True.
And anybody who's ever been divorced knows that emotions are pretty high, and so your intelligence is really low. So what you hope for is that whoever, you know, you end up with an advisor, that they have high emotional intelligence and that they're not emotional like you are. And I made a mistake. I mean, twice, I can tell you two times in recent history where I thought I was hiring the right lawyer and I wasn't. And to me, a lot of that is, okay, does the lawyer really care about you? And does the lawyer understand it? And here's the most important thing. Can they explain it to you? Where I should have run with my divorce lawyer is when the first time he said, you have a very complicated situation. And I should have said, you know what? I should leave now.
Right. That's a subtle way to say I'm not going to be able to understand it well enough to make it simple to go ahead and educate you on this.
Exactly. What he was really saying is that he didn't understand it. He was never going to understand it. And so he couldn't really help me with it. And we ended up in a really terrible result. You know, I have to take full responsibility. I'm not blaming him for it. You know, I'm the one who agreed to everything. Nobody badgered me into it. But at the same time, you know, if we have advisors, this is where we look for the advisor that can explain it to us. You know, Albert Einstein is quoted as saying that any six-year-old can explain something to a genius, but it takes a genius to explain something to a six-year-old.
Right.
And most of us, when it comes to taxes or it comes to law or it comes to finance, we're six-year-olds. And so what we want is we want to find advisors. And this is what I love about you and your show is that you're bringing on advisors who can explain something very simply. I was on actually the phone with Robert Kiyosaki earlier this morning, and we're working on a project together. And he said, Tom, just keep it simple. In fact, I was like 2 minutes into an explanation. It says, Tom, you lost me 2 minutes ago. He says, you've got to keep it. You got to make it more simple. He's always hammering me. I'm going, this is simple. And he goes, no, it's not. So I figure if I can explain it in such a way that Robert will tell me that it's simple, I'm good to go. He is the king of making things simple.
That's right. Think about that six-year-old when you're explaining things. And well, really, that's one reason I engaged ProVision. You know, words like fear and misunderstanding just don't seem to exist over there. You know, you do have the knowledge, you do have the confidence to take deductions that some people would consider aggressive. But when you're educated, you understand them and you can explain them to me in a way that makes it simple. I have all the confidence in the world myself, and I've got a lot of confidence in you. So as we're kind of tilting into quarter four here, Tom, any other thoughts? You mentioned audits on audit prevention strategies.
I'll give you three. Here you go. First one is documentation. Remember that if you don't document an expense as a deduction, it's not a deduction. So if you pretend to document, you get a pretend deduction. So you just got to make sure you're documenting. And the IRS is getting more and more sticklers for documentation. For example, a credit card statement is not a receipt. I don't care if it's the American Express statement that tells you exactly what happened. It is not a receipt. You have to keep the actual receipt, which means you have to scan the receipt. So you were asking me about software. One thing you want is you want to make sure you're scanning and you're keeping all your documents scanned because you don't want them paper, because you know what happens with paper receipts, right? They fade. Plus, who wants to keep paper receipts anyway? So scanning those receipts and putting on them, actually writing down. So if you're having a meal, business meal, who, what, when, where, and why? It's really simple. What'd you talk about, et cetera. So the documentation, that's key. Number two is your tax preparer. Your tax preparer will have a huge impact in two ways on your audit. First of all, they will impact whether you get audited. How, when we're preparing a tax return, we're looking at two things besides accuracy. We're looking at how do we reduce the client's taxes, and we're looking at how do we prevent an audit. So if I have a choice of how to report something, I was just looking at a tax return this morning. I'm going, okay, now how do I report this so the IRS readily identify it? So I'm not going to use the word red flag because I think red flag is a misnomer. But if I have a choice, let me give you a simple example. You go to a seminar on real estate. You write down seminar. That highlights it to the IRS. Seminars are not deductible. However, what is deductible is continuing education, continuing right. professional education. So instead, as a tax preparer, I'm going to change that term. I'm not going to write it down as seminars. I'm going to write it down as continuing professional education, if that's what it is. Because for most real estate investors, it is what it is. You're a real estate professional, at least you're a professional investor. And so even without a license, you're still a professional and you need continuing education to keep doing what you're doing. So that is continuing education. That is deductible. Seminars are not deductible. So it's very important that the tax preparer knows what to do with that information so that you reduce. Nobody can prevent an audit, but so that you reduce your risk of audit. And the third thing is, and this is the most important thing ever, and everybody should write this down, even if you've written it down before because you've heard me say it before, write it down again. And here's what I want every one of our listeners to promise, and it's this. I will never speak to the IRS. I will never speak to the IRS because here's the challenge. If you speak to the IRS, you will screw it up. I guarantee it. I equate it to, it's a little like, let's say you're going into a one-on-one tournament and you have a choice. You know, you're going up against a high school basketball player. They're younger than you. They're taller than you. They're more agile than you. Who's likely to win? Well, the high school basketball player is likely to win. But what if you could hire a LeBron James to go up or a Steph Curry to go up in your stead? Well, wouldn't you rather hire them and say, okay, you go do it. Okay, you might want to play that basketball game, but let me tell you, if you want to win, and you want to win for sure, you're going to hire somebody to do it for you. The same thing is true with an audit. Remember, you know less than the IRS agent about the tax law. But remember, in order to be an IRS agent, people who are IRS agents, they don't become IRS agents because it's the best job in the world.
Right.
Can you imagine a job where every one of your customers hates you? They don't just not want to see you. They hate you.
It's worse than being the referee.
It's way worse than being a referee. I mean, a referee, it's their job and it's okay and everything like that. And they're going to be fair, right? They're going to do their best to be fair. Nobody thinks the IRS is going to do their best to be fair. So there you have it.
Yeah.
You really have those three things. Number one is you're going to have good documentation. Number two is you're going to have a tax preparer who understands how to prepare that return to reduce audit risk. And number three is you're never going to talk to the IRS.
Yeah. And I'm sure a lot of us enjoy writing down those seven words. I will not talk to the IRS because, of course, we don't want to anyway.
Totally takes the stress out of it, doesn't it? I mean, you don't have to worry about it. You can relax. You can just say, I got it. ProVision can handle it. I don't have to worry about it.
Tom, it's been valuable as always. You know, when someone engages ProVision, they get to use the firm that I use. They get to use the firm that Robert Kiyosaki uses. You're brilliant at what you do. How can our listeners find out more about you and ProVision?
Well, just you can find us at taxfreewealthadvisor.com and taxfreewealthadvisor.com, or you can call us at 866-467-5809, 866-467-5809. And, you know, we love talking to your listeners, Keith. We love talking to real estate investors. It is one of our specialties, and it is important when you have a tax advisor that they do have a really good understanding of whatever your investments or your business are, because tax laws do vary from industry to industry.
Tom Wheelwright, it's been valuable as always. Thanks so much for coming back on to Get Rich Education.
Anytime, Keith, anytime. Thanks for having me.
Tom Wheelwright and ProVision, a firm that knows specifically how to reduce and even completely eliminate your tax burden for a real estate investor like you. If they find you $20,000 per year in tax savings, okay, that's a down payment on a single-family turnkey property right there every year. So consider using Garrett Sutton's firm at Corporate Direct, who will handle your asset protection. Extremely affordable and virtually bulletproof there at Corporate Direct. And today's guest, Tom Wheelwright at ProVision for those taxes. Amplify your wealth instead of giving it away to the IRS from the firm that's truly the best in the business. I just can't emphasize that enough. Corporate Direct and ProVision, they've been so good for me. What you've done when you've engaged them, just like Robert Kiyosaki has, and like I have, is that you've got two Rich Dad advisors that have got your back. Tom and Garrett know how to work with each other as well. Their information's also in the show notes for you, of course. Next week, we're getting kind of profound on you, going deep, deep into the mindset of how you can start with thinking to make yourself wealthier than you ever imagined, with mega influencer and best-selling author T. Harv Eker. After that show, we'll have an episode centered on turnkey property in the Texas metro markets. Thanks to Tom Wheelwright today. Until next week, I'm going to be thinking of as many ways as I possibly can to help you build your wealth. Live an abundant week for yourself. I'm your host, Keith Weinhold. Don't quit your daydream.
You've been listening to Get Rich Education, telling you what the wealthy won't tell you about real estate and investing.
Nothing on this show should be considered specific, personal, or professional advice. Please consult an appropriate tax, legal, real estate, financial, or business professional for individualized advice. Opinions of guests are their own. Information is not guaranteed. All investment strategies have the potential for profit or loss. The host is operating on behalf of Get Rich Education, LLC, exclusively.
Cashflow real estate investors nationwide and worldwide, this is Get Rich Education's Keith Weinhold. Forbes has rated Memphis, Tennessee as the number one cash flowing market in the world. Our good friends at Mid-South Homebuyers have been Memphis's premier turnkey real estate provider for 14 years with a stellar reputation and an A-plus rating with the Better Business Bureau. Owner Terry Kerr was born and raised in Memphis. Yeah, he knows the market and has renovated and sold over 1,000 houses in the Memphis area. Find out what their many repeat buyers already know. Their houses are completely renovated, even come with a one-year builder's warranty and a lifelong rental guarantee. They're a perfect fit for the first-time out-of-state investor or the seasoned investor diversifying their portfolio. Mid-South Homebuyers' friendly staff makes investing easy. Learn more at MidSouthHomebuyers.com or give them a call at 901-217-HOME. The preceding program was brought to you by your home for wealth building, GetRichEducation.com.